I represent the Norwegian Heritage Foundation. We are having a 20 years anniversary this year. We were founded in 1993. Our aim is conservation through use. I will give you now some examples from heritage in Norway who is in use. This is a classic farm in the central part of Norway. This is a fishing village in the northern Norway. This is a mountain farm in the west coast, in the fjords of Norway. This is examples of heritage, Norwegian heritage in use. This is a farm central placed in Norway in the winter time. We have much snow, as you can see, in Norway. And this is a, a traditional coaching with a 1,000 years old history. It's in the middle of Norway. So I will tell you about the project, Improve a Heritage Site. What we really try to do is to make young people proud of their heritage, local heritage sites. And we try to raise and improve awareness of heritage among children and young people. This is children from 7, also in some cases younger children, up to 17 years. This campaign was established in the year 2000. We have had 6 campaigns since the start, and we have a campaign this year. What's important is that the campaign requires small financial resources, and you don't need a big organization to run this campaign. And through collaboration with national and local partners, excellent results have been achieved. I give you some examples from different campaigns. Here you can see young people clearing a heritage site. Another example. Here is the situation before the children have cleared the site. This is the situation after. You can see a big change. This is children. This is a soldier's grave from World War II. Before the clearing, during the clearing, and after the clearing. It's important that, please note that also teachers, parents, and members of the local history societies are participating together with children. A Norwegian Heritage Foundation is managing the project. Here you can see all our partners, from the Ministry of Environment, the Directorate of Cultural Heritage, municipalities, and important also sponsors, and schools and teachers. Which results we have achieved? After 6 campaigns, we have cleared 1,200 heritage sites, which not would have been cleared if we haven't done this campaigns. We have mobilized 23,000 children and young people, and we have involved 1,100 schools out of 3,500 in Norway. Please note that almost 1/3 of all Norwegian elementary schools have participated in these campaigns. We have created awareness of neglected heritage sites. We have got cooperation between established players in the field, and also a better integration of first-generation Norwegians. Here is another example. This is a 1,000 years old burial site in the south part of Norway. This is before the clearing. The young boys are working very hard. also during the clearing. This is the result after. It's a quite a big difference from the start. This is the time dimension for each campaign. It's important for you to know that these campaigns can be implemented over a shorter time, but because of the long cold winters in Norway, we have to run this over 2 years. Another question is how to communicate with 3,500 schools. And we use new technology, we use websites, and we use email. And all information about the campaign are available on a website, and all software that we use is of a basic type. And we also cooperate with the Network of Environmental Science and the University of Bergen to make the knowledge known. This is this year's campaign. It's a bit of the map who is gone. It's not, we have not left it over to Sweden. It's just a technical problem. But you can see practically all of Norway have campaigns in improve a heritage site. So to the costs, the average in-house cost of managing the last four campaigns are about 40,000 euros. We also have additional costs for funding tools and equipment between 30,000 to 75,000 annually. And we also give prizes to the best examples. And you must also remember that the salaries and the general costs in Norway is about 65% higher than the average within the European Union. So with the cost level in the European Union, each campaign can be run for 25,000 euros. Here's another example of clearing a heritage site. This is the in the south of Norway. Some important lessons that we have learned. School children can strongly identify with local heritage sites. They become ambassadors for these heritage sites in their own nearby their home. And local heritage projects may also give the school children a better comprehension of other school subjects. And we also have learned that to identify public and private sponsors, it's important to have access to the school organization and motivated teachers, and involve local authorities. And also to keep a record of all the school projects and evaluate for future documentation and education. How can this project be a guide to others? By identifying partners, private and public, by mobilizing schools, teachers, and local museums, history societies, and local authorities, to give attention to local heritage site, and the communication tools that we use are simply and easily transferable. It's a low-cost project, which sponsors traditionally want to identify with. Here are some more pictures of young Norwegians clearing heritage sites. And here is from Lisboa in June 2012 with Professor Tomislav Sola. And we are very proud to win this prize. It has meant a great deal. It made it easier to get sponsors for the campaigns. Very much media about the prize. So it meant very much for the Norwegian Heritage Foundation. Please contact us for further information. Thank you.